Mr. Ford, your witness.
You testified earlier that Dr. Whitten left the lab at 7 p.m.?
Uh-huh. I mean, yes.
How long was your shift that night?
3 to 10.
7 hours? Must have taken restroom breaks occasionally. You could have missed Dr. Whitten re-entering the building.
I don't think I took any breaks after 7.
You don't think?
Objection. Badgering the witness.
Overruled.
You're under oath, Mary. Can you state with certainty that you never left your post after 7 p.m.?
No, I just...
You just...
I'm just not sure.
So, Professor Whitten may have re-entered the building while you were away from the security desk. In fact, she may never have left.
No, I really think...
A lot of middle-aged brunettes work at the lab. You could have mistaken someone else for her.
I'm pretty sure.
Pretty sure? Are you or are you not absolutely certain you saw Dr. Whitten that night?
Yes.
We went through all those questions in prep.
More than once.
Some witnesses get intimidated by court. There's not much you can do to prepare for that. Make sure Walt holds up.
So, how damaging was that?
It wasn't good. But we still got the threatening letters in Walt.
Do you and Walt have any history between you?
Between... No, no, no.
He just said that you two really bonded at a conference in St. Louis.
Oh, we both attended it. We sat next to each other at an award banquet.
Oh, the night he won an award? The cover article he wrote for the Journal of Quantum Physics turns out to be 3 paragraphs on page 46.
We can't put someone who embellishes like that on the stand.
No, what we can't do is elicit perjure testimony, so make sure he doesn't perjure himself.
But he's...
You never handed the perfect witness. You make the perfect witness.